We want you to develop a mindset of being both curious and skeptical when you work with data. To help you get into this mindset, I want to share another conversation that I had with Aude. In this next video, I want you to listen to Aude's work and look out for how she demonstrated this exact mindset.
So we gathered all the hometowns and current cities from the users, and I was looking at conditional probabilities. Given a hometown, what is the probability that you currently live in each different cities? Like, for example, given that your hometown is New York, what is the probability that you live in Chicago, or that you live in, that you still live in New York, or that you live in San Francisco or Paris, and so on? And what I was expecting is that at least the most likely city where you would live right now would be the city where your hometown is. If you grew up in Chicago, the most likely place that you're going to be now is still Chicago. You could be moving as well, but the most likely place would remain your hometown. But I saw a fair number of cases where the most likely current city was different from the hometown, and that was with a fairly high probability. And I was fairly surprised. I was wondering if I had had a problem in my computations, if there was some issues with the data upstream of what I was doing. So I decided to put all these cities on a map, all the pairs of hometowns and current cities for which the most likely current city was different from the hometown. And what we saw on this map was really fascinating, because that was really not what we were expecting. It was not a bug in the code. We were really seeing patterns arise. Here we only plotted the pairs of hometown and current city, so there's no movement between the pairs. But what we see is that a lot of these cities for which the most likely current city is different from the hometown arise in West Africa, or in India, or in like Turkey, which we were not necessarily expecting at the beginning. And there was really this trend of like a lot of small cities all moving to the same current city. And so we decided to dig up more into it. One thing that happens is that sometimes the distribution of the current city is very flat. Given that you grew up in, let's say, Paris, maybe you're still living in Paris, but maybe you live in like one of the 1,000 cities in the suburbs. And so the distribution is really flat. And so we had to decide what was considered as a coordinated migration. We decided that, yeah, the probability to move to that city is high enough that we're considering that. And the other thing that we had to think about is that if you look at the map at the world scale, or if you zoom to a very specific areas, you don't want to see the same things. So we also wanted to have some interactivity in the visualization. And so we decided to use D3, which is a JavaScript-based visualization framework, which enables you to have a lot of interactivity with your data, and enabled us to do a lot of data exploration and so on.